Suspended Bumbon Mayor Alice Goh remains in the Philippines. That's according to Senator Sherwin Gatchalian after the upper chamber failed to serve the arrest order against Goh. The Senate Sergeant at Arms searched all of the mayor's possible hiding places in Tarlac, Bulacan, and Valenzuela, but failed to locate her or her siblings. Gatchalian says Goh is unable to leave the country due to the hold departure order against her. The mayor's lawyer, attorney Stephen David, meanwhile insists his client fears for her life after receiving death threats.
Naniniwala ako nasa Pilipinas siya kasi nga, well, una-una, ang higpit ng lookout sa immigration. Natatakot siya. Marami kasing nananakot sa kanya, maraming threats. So, natatakot siya sa security niya, tsaka kung ano pwede mangyari kung makulong siya. Pero ang advice natin sa kanya, kasi hindi ka naman pwede magtago habang buhay, di ba? So, at saka ito, remember, ito, Senate warrant of arrest. So, hindi naman ito para parusahan ka or what. Ito, kaya kasi nusubina para lang mag-testify ka.
Goh's former accountant, Nancy Gamo, meanwhile, was found and brought to the Senate where she underwent a medical checkup. The Senate issued the arrest order Saturday after Goh and her family members snubbed the Senate hearings into their alleged links to illegal POGOs. Philippine House lawmakers seek a probe into the alleged scheme of issuing fake birth certificates to Chinese nationals to allow them to obtain Philippine passports. The so-called Young Guns Bloc of the House of Representatives calls the scheme unacceptable. It says there is a need to safeguard and strengthen the processes at local civil registries to stop fraudulent activities. The lawmakers add there should be no fake Filipinos. Last week, the National Bureau of Investigation uncovered the scheme in Davao City, where nearly 200 Chinese nationals were given fake birth certificates. Oil prices heading lower Tuesday after four straight weeks of increases. Kerosene will see the biggest drop of 1 peso and 15 centavos per liter, while a liter of gasoline and diesel will decrease by 60 and 95 centavos respectively. The Energy Department cites higher oil production in the U.S. and lower consumer confidence in China for the rollback. More rainy days ahead with a brewing storm down south. Let's get an outlook on the weather from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. A low-pressure area formed from a cloud cluster east of Mindanao at 8 this Monday morning. The LPA was located 485 kilometers east of Davao City. State Weather Bureau Pagasa said the LPA may develop into a tropical cyclone in the next 24 to 48 hours. It will be assigned the local name Butchoy. Initial forecast shows a northwestward movement of a weak storm crossing the Visayas and southern Luzon between Wednesday and Friday. It may enhance the southwest monsoon or Habagat. And please continue monitoring up for updates on this weather disturbance as the forecast will still change. But this payday Monday, the tropical extension of the LPA will bring scattered rains over the eastern portions of Caraga and Davao region. Scattered rains are also experienced over Palawan, Occidental Mindoro, and Sulu Archipelago brought by the Habagat. Later today, thunderstorms are likely over the rest of the country, especially over southern Luzon, western and eastern Visayas, and most of Mindanao. And here in Metro Manila, the sky is now overcast with possible thunderstorms this afternoon or evening. That's the latest on the weather. This is Ariel Rojas. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Ariel Rojas, there joining us live.